and as you can see, being very close pressed by Kerry Moore. Two New Zealanders fighting out the Clubman final.
So fast is this circuit at Oran Park today that the top 11 drivers in this class have all undercut the existing lap record in practice.
In fact, the track has been resurfaced, which has helped that, but then again, in some parts, it's breaking up a little bit and become pretty bumpy. Into the tight infield section, Bridgestone Loop. Form of Ray Hart. You can see him sitting fairly forward, plenty of shoulders and elbows into the wheel work. Then up the bridge, where up to around 120 kilometres an hour is the norm. Off the bridge, and then while they're turning right, have to come down into this Yamaha Hill section, a series of S's. Very, very tight and tricky indeed.
Hart has built this Kiwi cart especially for himself. It's developed to the Bridgestone tyres that he uses in New Zealand and here in Australia as well, because the relationship between tyres and the chassis is all important in kart racing. He's built this thing to be very narrow in the waist, to be able to put more pressure on the tyres, to keep the front end down and to stop it washing out in the slower corners. And he's delighted with the way it's working. But while the chassis is working well, the engine isn't his. He's actually borrowed it from a fellow competitor in New Zealand. In a recent series, he was being knocked off by his fellow competitor, Warren Vining, and was so impressed with the engine that he said, hey, listen, can I borrow it for the Castrol car free in Australia?
Not surprising that Ray Hart is quick in this area, because the Yamaha class, very similar to this, is the premier class over there. Panel beater by trade, but a kart competitor for 15 years. He didn't start until 20 years of age.
Kerry Moore in second position, also in a Kiwi kart, doing well to cling to the back of Ray Hart. On Yamaha engines, the KT100S engine, the piston port engine, they put out about 15 brake horsepower compared to the 20 brake horsepower carts we'll see in the international class later this afternoon.
In fact, Hart has just lapped international motorcycle rider Wayne Gardner. He's driving cart number 81, just been lapped by them, had trouble in an earlier heat. This is absolutely his first day of racing carts. There he was in the blue leathers, in that pair of carts that went before that group. He's just going up to the bridge there, being lapped now by the second place cart. Gardner decided only about a week ago that he'd like to go kart racing, thought it would develop his skills for an ultimate ambition of going car racing later. He's been going very well today, finished sixth in one heat, but he was punched off in one, so he started well down in this one, 25th grid position, and has had further problems during this race. And of course he has to be very, very careful as to what he does to ensure that he remains fit for his motorcycle career, which includes a weekend after this meeting, but prior to you watching this telecast, a superbike race in Japan.
1.65 seconds now separates Ray Hart from Kerry Moore, and that's a lifetime in kart racing, because these karts are usually so close to each other. But that's the way that Hart's attacked this weekend. In fact, in establishing his pole position time, he was almost half a second faster than Gavin Field, a fellow New Zealand driver again in the Techno car. And half a second from pole, the second position, it's really quite incredible.
Yamaha engines for this class of kart around $600, and then of course all competitors are racing on the same tyre. Bridgestone YAK compound tyres. So drivers in that sense are very equal. The other advantage of karting is that there is an all-up minimum weight for each particular class, which is driver and vehicle, so that a light person doesn't have an advantage as he does on motorbikes and most forms of car racing. And for clubmen, it's 130 kilos with a machine that delivers probably around 15 brake horsepower.
That's our race leader, Ray Hart. Behind him and all he sees is daylight. Coming up for a big afternoon, however, because he's also competing in the international class, where he's been having his difficulties. He was T-boned by a competitor in the prologue earlier today, and it broke his disc brake on his international class of kart, and that's created immense difficulties for him. In fact, he parked this kart in the pits, this one we're watching now, and has been working furiously on his international class kart all day. So again, it's a tribute to just how well he's put this vehicle together that it's taken almost minimal preparation today.
Just easing his fingers, giving you an idea of how hard it is physically. Gavin Field in ninth, third place. And just down the straight there, very sensible, very relaxed driver, obviously. Just relaxing and easing his fingers, then gripping the wheel so hard. Big wraparound seats because there's no belts holding the drivers in. And so the only thing they have to keep them in position under incredible cornering forces is pushing themselves back into the very light fiberglass wraparound seat. Left foot's always on the brake, right foot's always on the throttle. And I mean nearly always, it very rarely lifts off at all. Sometimes the braking is just left foot against the throttle. For slower corners, of course, they do lift off the throttle. Fixed gears, they have to be lifted in the air and then dropped on the ground when the runner lifting, it's got a bit of pace because there's no freewheeling or gears or clutch.
That's Des Fleet, another New Zealander, coming up to challenge kart 9, Gavin Field. If you occasionally see cars in the background, you should be aware that Oran Park has two circuits capable of operating independently, and there's a club lap dash on today, so occasionally you'll see a race car come into shot as well. Fleet now giving some curry to Field. Strong New Zealand contingent over in Australia for this premier kart race. Fleet now has got the inside running, but he can't do it. Field slams across in front of him, and that's really shutting the gate through there. Field takes the classic blocking line. Fleet is capable of throwing his kart wide to get up much more speed, but then loses it all in that left-hand corner, because he has to brake to the pace of the vehicle in front of him, so it's almost no advantage to take a fast lane into the corner. There's an altercation between two karts, one of them kart 25, John Dark, who probably is, having lost his opportunity in this Clubman event. And the competitor slightly injured on the other side of the track, but it's very, very difficult to hurt yourself in kart racing. He comes back to the dice for third position between kart 9, Gavin Field, and kart 6, Des Fleet.
Further back in the field is a 9-times Australian champion, John Pizzaro. He's in 66. And that 9th position at the moment. John's been having a little bit of a truck problem. Rode very well recently in Hong Kong.
Oh, and look at Fleet across the top there. Is Field holding him up or what? Fleet just wants to get through. fleet driving a thing called a topless, which is not a New Zealand way of saying he's not wearing his bash hat. Although it could be.
Actually, it's originally a Swiss brand called Swiss Hutlers. There's Pizarro. But now being made locally, a guy called David Craig. This is John Pizarro. Won't admit his age, probably mid-40s. Been karting for more than 20 years. Comes from Parks, has a kart shop there, and a fierce competitor, and a very, very successful one.
Pizarro has
his behind him, David Lawton.
Pizarro has a small surprise for us coming up later in the day, where through the magic of television we'll take you for a ride in one of these carts at high speed, but more of that later.
Like a number of carters, Drew Price notably, who makes DPE carts and is now, of course, a works driver with Toyota, is in his own cart, a sprinter cart.
Pizarro describes himself as a farmer and cart manufacturer.
Born near here.
At Parks, it's only just up the road.
No, he's born, in fact, just on the western suburbs edge of Sydney, near Cabramatta. Wayne Gardner trying to choke the carburetor, i.e. reduce the airflow, richen the mixture by covering the air intake, the air filter with his hand. Starting to learn some of the tricks of the trade, Gardner. Not looking at his best in this race. He's been hit twice by other drivers, including once where he reckoned he was given a really hard time, punched off the track and rather worried about hurting himself, not because he's afraid of being hurt per se, but because he recognises an enormous responsibility of Honda, with whom he's contracted. Revealed today, Wayne Gardner, that he would very, very much like a drive in this year's James Hardy 1000. And as one other motorcycle ace seems to be headed that way, Graham Crosby having his first run in Australia in a car this weekend, the Holden Commodore he just bought from Ray Smith in New Zealand, who he was sharing with Denny Hong. Well then, perhaps Gardner could get together with somebody such as that. There he is, back in the field. Gardner's number flapping about. Wollongong Kart Centre looking after it for him.
Starting.
Putting it back in the shed. Perhaps one more outing before the motorcycle season starts. And then later in the year, he'll be back into it again.
And starting a new fashion trend today by wearing skid pads on his knees. Unusual for a carter, but nonetheless, it could come in handy.
They were the surfers' high side of leathers, actually.
Laps remaining, in fact three laps remaining in this Yamaha Challenge Clubman race. And there's the leader, Ray Hart, who looks destined to be a flag-to-flag finisher. Because he's some 4.7 seconds in front of Kerry Moore in second position. And that is like 20 laps in a car race. So to Ray Hart, a great run. Two laps now to go for Ray Hart. And what a great way to debut a new kart, this Kiwi kart. And that should mean a few sales for Ray Hart when he gets back to New Zealand, if in fact he doesn't sell this before he goes.
That's a fairly equivalent debut, I suspect, to New Zealand's America's Cup yacht. About as unheralded when it got here, with about as much development behind it, but coming out straight away as a winning machine. Coming around to complete lap 24. Out now on his final, the 36-year-old, tall, lanky, bespectacled New Zealander, Ray Hart.
Just one corner remaining for Ray Hart now, and he comes up to get the checkered flag and win the Yamaha Challenge Clubman race over 25 laps at Oran Park. Second place goes to Kart 4, Kerry Moore. And then this race now coming up to third position will be resolved, I think, in favour of Kart 9. That's Gavin Field from Des Fleet, Kart 6.
That is a very long and tiring race in a kart. Nearly 16 minutes, 15 minutes 51.12 seconds, and averaging 86 kilometres an hour around an 863-metre circuit. That really is flying. So the official result of the Yamaha Challenge Clubman Class final over 25 laps, number 3 Ray Hart from number 4 Kerry Moore, both of them New Zealanders, both of them in Demon X carts, and in third place in 9, Gavin Field in a Techno.
A delighted winner of the Yamaha Challenge is Ray Hart. Ray, congratulations. It's difficult to think of anyone who's actually won on a debut of a new machine. You must be very pleased.
Yes, we are very pleased. The Kiwi Kart has just finished for this series, and we're delighted in the way it's handling.
That seemed to